Recently, viewer All About Maddie left a comment asking for us to do a video about the top strangest things that can happen during lucid dreaming. Well, the cool thing about lucid dreaming is that anything can happen. But it led me to think a little deeper and ask the question, why do we actually dream? Dreams have fascinated philosophers for thousands of years. We spend one third of our life in this paralyzed, coma-like state where our minds take control and make up the most craziest scenarios. So you'd think by now we'd have a good understanding as to why we sleep and dream. As it turns out, not quite. You see, we sleep when we're tired to recharge our batteries. But as we already know, we don't get our energy from sleep, but rather from food. So if sleep isn't for energy, then what is it for? Well, maybe it's a way of switching off our mind, letting it cool off from all the information and stresses of everyday life. Sounds plausible, but the only problem is our minds are more active when we're sleeping than when we're awake. Al Herpin is a man born in 1862 who claims he's never slept. He said he developed a rare case of insomnia whereby he just couldn't sleep. Medical professionals inspected his house and found no bed or sleep-related furniture. However, since he's never officially been recorded to never sleeping, his claims are just claims. Randy Gardner, however, is the person officially credited for staying awake the longest. In an experiment in 1964, he managed to stay awake for a whole 11 days and 24 minutes. What's interesting is the effects it had on Randy's overall health. For the first few days of the experiment, Randy displayed serious cognitive and behavioral changes. Things like moodiness, loss of concentration and short-term memory, paranoia, and even hallucinations. However, on the final day of the experiment, Randy behaved like normal. He spoke without slurring or stumbling his words and in general appeared to be in excellent health. He even beat one of the researchers at pinball. What's amazing about the whole experiment is that Randy displayed very similar signs to an addict going cold turkey. The first part is very difficult, just like withdrawal symptoms from any addictive substance. However, once the addiction is broken, the person becomes themselves again. So is sleep really just an addiction? You see, everybody does dream, and even if you think you don't, you do, you just can't remember it. The reason we have such crazy vivid dreams is due to a chemical released by our pineal gland called DMT. DMT is a psychedelic compound and if sold as a drug is very illegal. Essentially, every time you go to sleep, you are getting high. Now, although it's not addictive like heroin or cocaine, users do develop a dependency on the drug. Looking at our evolutionary history, it makes perfect sense why our body would release such a powerful drug. Before medicine and painkillers were ever invented, the only relief from serious injury or pain would be to go to sleep. Sleep also helps our body relax, and during serious injury, that can even save your life. Maybe sleep is just an addiction, or more accurately a habit we just kind of accept, something that technically speaking in this day and age is not really needed anymore. And that's all this is, it's a maybe, a theory, because we honestly don't know why we sleep or dream. The most popular theory is that sleep allows our minds to organize all the new information we take in daily. However, whatever the truth is, it sure is cool to dream about the theories behind it. And remember, until next time, feed your mind.